Okay, sir. I'm sorry. Can you tell us something? Because I heard right in the middle of something. You're with who again?
I'm with Braun U.S. State Director, I know you, and when you mentioned D.C., I'm actually based out of Indianapolis.
This is
obviously,
though,
the Senate
yeah.
has the 202 area code.
Yeah, the 200 area code comes up on my caller ID, that's why I was asking.
Yeah.
Okay, so you're with Senator Braun's office.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
He let me know this morning that you had reached out and had some questions about your the case you raised with our office last week or in the previous weeks.
Yes, sir.
I checked with our casework team, and they've confirmed through the VA that you don't currently have a pending case with the VA that they can actually work with an appeal. The appeal had been closed out, and so there's not actually a pending case at the VA that we can work on your behalf and communicate on your behalf with the VA currently. So I did speak with our casework team. The senator wanted me to touch base with you and see what we might be able to further do for you or how we might be able to help moving from here, or if you planned on having a new case at the VA that we could be helpful with. But the current, without there being a pending case, there's really not a whole lot we can do functionally. So just wanted to check in and see how we could be helpful.
Well, I tell you what, I appreciate you taking the time to contact me back. Thank you. Second here, I have not had a chance yet to contact Mr. Braun back. I've actually not been feeling well with the preparation of having open heart surgery, so I'm not doing very well right now. I've got to have a valve repair to replace that in my medical records from the VA as of 1995 to today, because of the way that my records were handled. Some of the reasons that I even contacted you trying to get the matter figured out of why the VA has handled the situation they have been for so long, and then therefore anytime any inquiry was made to medical records and so on and so forth, where I am now in dealing. Thankfully, I finally got a doctor. It only took me literally almost dropping dead from a heart attack at church with a church dinner party here a couple of weeks ago. Anyway, I'm in the process. I haven't talked to Mr. Braun. He called me. I will be contacting him back to talk to him again about it. But nonetheless, the problem seems to be that I don't think that the letters that I have wrote nor the inquiry from the past where Senator Donnelly was handling my case and the long-standing petitions of, hey, look, you have a severe problem with the FDA, the FCC, the VA, and the manner of which related to my entire case is being handled. I have repeatedly tried after the Minamata Convention of 2013, where the federal government changed its standing to recognize the symptomatology of the heavy metal poisoning in the theoretical questions then from as early as World War II to the actual scientific fact being dated related to the symptomatology with the Hitler from Bridge Anomaly as recent as the events in Cuba with the ambassadors and the Marine Corps embassy duty and so on, with the difference between the sonic weaponry question versus your EMF, non-ionizing radiation radio frequency effect, whether it was weaponized or is it the common everyday factor which they have ignored since the Church Committee of 75. My questions that I tried to present in that letter that I sent to you guys were if your office staff had actually followed up to find where my records from Joe Donnelly's office was supposed to have been transferred to Mr. Braun's office after the election, respectfully so, which I have never ever gotten a detailed response to that changeover, confirmation to changeover, to actually start to make the inquiries to establish the communication to relate the concerns illustrate the merit of my complaint of where the FCC is not adhering to the relevant directives when it comes to that notice of inquiry docket 1384 from 2013 related to non-ionizing radiation, nor should I say the FDA, simultaneously in the same year through the State Department, subsequently John Kerry went to Japan and signed that Minamata Convention, which formally outlines a formal acknowledgement change to the legal nature of uses of dental silver mercury amalgam fillings, and which would translate to my petitions on the facts behind, the history behind what is now my act, part of my active medical record and pending claims that I'm trying to get reestablished. The VA, which I'm trying to file through, I've got a VA lawyer, Chisholm and Kilpatrick, is working on it. The VA in March or so sent me a letter to confirm, as that letter said that they just simply did not even notify the lawyer and or myself of the new, it just happened to be that one, therefore was for reevaluation for your site for the PTSD, but yet they never notified either one of us that there was ever an appointment. They just simply denied the claim, wrote it off, and that was the end of it, which seems to be the common nature of how my claim has been handled ever since I filed it myself, pro se, in 1997, between 1997 and 1999. And granted, the original was based upon the vaccinations. As I learned or was learning and came to learn or understand the context of what the Hitler Molar anomaly was, it was adding to my medical health conditions. If the caseworker had actually done what I tried to just explain, to try to trace back where I started, to see where I'm at when it comes to even dealing with civilian doctors, where the federal agencies are not disseminating the information, they are not putting any information out to the public, so therefore the doctors will be aware of it, to know that there has been an actual federal acknowledgement, something that should be changed. Health departments are definitely not notified. If they had actually done the research, they'd find out that I've even filed with through the Justice Department asking them why isn't or where is the public notification. When I tried to file, even through the Medicaid and Medicare, to try to get them to understand, whereas I was being grossly misdiagnosed and just simply blown off as a drug addict or just a general run-of-the-mill schizophrenic or whatever, when I tried to actually show the medical records and the timelines and so on and so forth, I couldn't even get health professions bureaus to actually investigate it. They would simply refuse it and would even deny the existence of the Minamata Convention directives or the sentiment of concern of where even the FCC's rating for hazards without the dental amalgam to show it started at 3 gigahertz, 3 to 6, where now they're pushing the 5G, so that your general environmental average power density is going to increase 8 times fold. Now, I don't use wireless objects. I don't know, I don't even have a cell phone. I don't even have a radio in a house. Everything I have is hardwired from my laptop that I've got. The point is that with that, there is no adjustment through any of the federal agencies, including the FDA, to acknowledge any facet of the Hitler Molar anomaly. None of it. Even after the health profession, or even after, Senator Arlington Specter, before he died, and before the Government Accountability Office in 2012 started to actually try to push a little further to ask more questions about the direct device use, proximity factors, and would be cancer factor. There have been but one set of doctors that have actually acknowledged exactly what I just said about a portion of the Hitler Molar Mic, and that was Dr. Joel McClosewicz with the Bridge Anomaly in California. He actually does cite the leaching blood-brain barrier factor with the dental amalgam issue. And again, as of today, even in his own acknowledgments and as himself in trying to argue this and win in court, and he did win, there is no update. And anybody that tries to file with the FCC to get them to update their own directives, they don't or will not acknowledge their own directives to investigate. And their own investigation calls for paragraph 205, a complete solicitation for a reevaluation of all frequencies, which would go all the way back to the original laws from where it would go back to the very beginning, like which is dictated and hinted at, even in OSS, Department of Defense, Department of War training videos with the cartoon that was put out to train the troops in World War II called Private Snafu Demon Traps 1944. The very likeness of that was even trained for by then. It is the federal agencies of which Mike Braun would have authority over are blatantly being allowed to ignore it in its entirety, even though they are seemingly making effort to do so, to acknowledge it. I even have gone so far as to talk to Mr. Ed Metaply, who was supposed to have been the program project director for this implementation of the notice of inquiry docket 1384 and the outlines of directives in paragraph 205. And when I talked to him, he told me that he's never received funding, budget, manpower, or anything. He really didn't know much or anything more about it. And that was almost 5 years ago. As I continue to monitor the situation, it is still the same. It is completely ignored. If your gentleman and caseworker had actually followed through, one, he would have actually helped me follow through with a complaint to see why the VA just blew me off like that when they did, and or help me try to understand the context of why the testing and so on and so forth is so lacking in the way it does even through the compensation of pensions and claims, which I tried to illustrate, to lead me to continue to be either denied or played off as merely mentally ill versus the actual physical condition I have, which in part right now I'm getting ready to have surgery for. It doesn't seem like your office, with all due respect, I know you guys are just getting in and just getting going, but yet if they had actually followed through the background, they would have found that, you know, the reasons that the VA just simply blew it off, they should have made some sort of inquiry to find out why they simply didn't even bother notifying anybody, which would lead to the questions that I presented about the testing, the acknowledgement, the lack of implementation, the coordination from the various different agencies. Even as, like I said, the most recent fact was actually acknowledged and investigated by the military defense, etc., when it came to the events in Cuba, which is literally almost the exact same symptomatology in an actual warfare context, versus the ignored comorbidity factor. Now, so what I found, like I said, it just didn't seem, by what I saw, so much was left out of the letter that he didn't even, that was what wasn't even addressed. And that really disturbs me, considering, you know, I'm getting ready to go in for surgery, and I still can't get a straight answer. The answers that I'm getting are extremely vague, they're extremely shallow, they're not following through. The agencies that can be contacted, communicated with to find out why they're dragging their feet, you know, what's the deal with actually taking action with the Minamata or that does of inquiry, but completely and utterly ignore any inquiry to ask why are the people that are in charge of running the program, they're not even being given the manpower, the money. Taking petitions is absolutely useless because of the responses you get from, like I said, the FDA or FCC, they won't even acknowledge their own actions. which is leading to humongous medical malpractice, neglect, misdiagnosis, mistreatment. That's why I called. Joe Donnelly and they were following up good, but honestly, I'm glad he's gone. I don't think he did a very good job at all. I'm a little concerned for what I'm seeing in his most recent letter and the way it was responded to. I'm seeing the same patterns popping up again. And that's why I contacted the Election Bureau in Indianapolis and got a copy of his candidacy form and got his home phone number and his home address so I can make direct contact with him, because I'm tired of the way this is being handled. Their office staff and so on, I don't understand the why that they react. They do, so I just simply start making direct contact, obviously peaceably and so on, as much as I possibly can, to get him to formally recognize the situation that he needs to get on the ball and start forcing these federal agencies to acknowledge what has been known as early as it was written in training videos as early as 1944. I mean, my God, the whole history behind the Adolf Hitler phone bridge, the trance through the whole issue behind the Church Committee of 75 after JFK, it has now been seen in a true context of concerns of, are we actually in an act of war, or are we just seeing the product of fact of technology influencing culture with the most recent events in Cuba, which reflect upon the concerns during the Cold War, for crying out loud. So, if I'm understanding the context, watching the news, which really disturbs me even more so, is to know that as I've looked at Hillary Clinton and looking at her face value for some of her own errors and mistakes and so on, it's seeming like everything that I was thrown out of the military for was made a complete mockery, as long as, well, including the entire context of the Church Committee, behind the concerns of the very confusions for which would lead to the concerns of national security, or the manipulations of political officials or influence of political officials would have, as I understand, was a concern that would have possibly led to nuclear war, because of the opinions of things being used as an act of warfare being mistaken as an act of warfare. I understand that same context was brought up with Russia, if I may, with the Poland air crash. Some of the same questions behind some of the investigations with that. So as to look at the perspectives of where I'm coming through, or what after I went through with the military, to where is now active, that was even brought up as recent as General Shelton with Light Squared debate with the White House, when they were talking about increasing the saturations, increasing the average environmental power densities. I understand the context of his concerns. Why they asked him to lie about it was pretty much exactly what I'm dealing with right now, which both the Mid-Atlantic Convention took to address and that notice of inquiry. But yet, as I am right now talking to you, explaining to you the exact same thing, it's not being addressed. It's being passed off. And inquiries is like what I just made. I got the reply back, well, you know, it is half-heartedly replied to. That's unacceptable. It's totally unacceptable. There are way too many people that have, you know, as I just said, you know, only God knows how many people out there are affected by us and don't even rise to understand, versus someone like myself that does, that has replied. We're made to seem like crazy people, and that's just not right. So that's why I'm calling. I will contact Mr. Braun back. I will follow up. I'm going to be asking him the exact same questions to get the answers, because, like I said, as it is right now, the FDA is allowed to run amok and do whatever they want. The FCC is allowed to do the exact same thing. They're protecting the industry on two different fronts, literally ignoring the true hazards of those that were actually able to even use as test subjects to confirm, to test for the national defense. So I think that needs to be addressed, and that's why I'm contacting him. And I would appreciate if you relay this message to him. I don't like the way that I'm being treated with this. And I find it just really, really, really disturbing. And that I would have to go so far as to actually track down the man's home number and home address and start making contact him with, at home to let him know what's going on. So, but nonetheless, I will, and I appreciate you calling. Like I said, you guys need to get off the ball and start dealing with this, because, like I said, I can't even go to the doctor up to an hour and try to get ultimate help for it, because the way, thankfully, something has finally broken and happened. Like I said, it took me literally dropping almost dead of a heart attack here just a couple weeks ago to get the attention. And I couldn't tell you how many times I've been in the hospital or equivalent facts to it, which I have been basically, it's though they took the test, they acknowledged the facts, I say what I had to say, and they just simply released me and ignored me.
Sure. Now, so just want to, I don't mean to cut you off, but I want to let you know of a couple things here and respond to a couple things you said. Just for your awareness, you mentioned a couple minutes ago about not sure when the records from Senator Conway's office got to our office.
Yes, sir.
Just so you know, Senator Donnelly's senior staff met with our senior staff during the transition, and they had indicated that what they had planned on doing was closing out all the casework they could close out between the election and when we took office, and anything left over or anything that came in to their office between the two, they were sending to Senator Young's office.
Yeah, Senator Young. It just so happens to be Senator Young already knew, and I'm in the process of working, still trying to get the same. I I've even had his too. I'm going through the same process, and I'm still pushing him. He knows about it. And his office was bending over backwards beforehand to help me, and for some reason or other, the transition portion seemed to put me in the same limbo scenario. So that's why I'm obviously, why I'm obviously still persistent. The matter still exists. And I tried to get over to Trey Hollingsworth's office, and I ran into the situation where I wish I had recorded it, but the guy basically over the phone, the caseworker, told me that what I said or my concerns didn't even exist and hung up. And he tried to get the context after the fact about where did my file go after I was promised in writing and so on and so forth. It would be transferred. It would be looked into. You're not just going to be left in limbo, sir, because his office staff here in Bloomington. The guy, he bent over backwards to try to help me. And once the election changed, and as you're explaining, we're trying to figure out who gets what where, what cases are just, have already been settled or whatever, I can understand that. But where mine has been, as far, like I said, when it came to between jurisdictional points and the transfer from congressman to senator or congressman, as of to date, even Trey, I'm still trying to find Trey Hollingsworth's office to get it, which I finally got his home number and address and so on and so forth. My next step is to go visit the man personally and bring it to his attention peaceably, because the way this has been treated is basically, like his office basically told me, they record everything. I was told what I said didn't exist, and he had no clue what I was trying to talk to explain to him. So I'm hoping that doesn't get, we're just not getting started with you, so I'm hoping that, now we can move forward, and we can try to get a better response and a better working with one another to be able to get these questions answered and dealt with.
Sure, so, and that's certainly one of the reasons I'm calling. Understanding everything you just said, I can appreciate that, but just so I the office works. Once we've got a case that comes in our office, which obviously yours came in our office this month, our caseworkers contact the federal agencies, and so we contacted the VA.
Well,
the VA has told us, and I believe that...
I'm sitting here looking at this letter, you're absolutely right, but they did not address the fact of what I detailed out about why the heck would they just simply not even notify me and continue to play this pussyfoot with me, actually with 7 appointments that has pending factors with a lawyer. The lawyer's bringing it up. Justin Kilpatrick is working on it. But that's, I understand that, but the fact is that it's because of the way that they keep handling this, they keep pushing it back, which makes it delayed more problems on top of it. This thing with the letter, my inquiry with the VA, that wasn't the only matter of entity that I asked to be dealt with, and that was the only thing that I got a response back from. And in and itself, wasn't very complete, because I'm sitting here looking at the letter.
Right, and I saw a copy of the letter that we received. I believe our caseworker sent you, I'm looking at it too, our caseworker sent you the letter that we received from the VA that stated you don't currently have a case.
Right, because I've got the VA lawyer is doing what they can to petition and let them know that they just simply dropped it, prematurely and so on and so forth. Granted, that's going to take more time. But this has been a consistent action of delay in one manner or another since I filed this thing in 1998. And I'm getting a little annoyed with it. And, like I said, as I'm still trying to fight to get records straight and medical records straight and information to be able to get how many times it's ever referred to, it's a nightmare. But as for the letter matter here, on the rest of the question, sir, there's no other response to say that your office did anything at all to communicate with the FCC, the FDA, Health and Human Services, none of the above. That's unacceptable. Why would they just simply send me a portion of it, which wasn't really done very well at all, to where we are right now?
We'll go back and look into our records here in just a second.
I understand what you said about the matter of transferring records from office and so on, but if you just, what you just said a minute ago, and I hope I'm not trying to miscite you here, your office should have gotten a mountain of inquiries and emails to transfer over to the existence of a still pending set of inquiries. The VA matter was just a portion of it. The FCC, the FDA, Health and Human Services, and so on, relative to the rest of my petition, is still being ignored. And your office just proved the consistency of what I've dealt with the letter that I just got back. It didn't include any of the other things. None of it.
I'm trying to confirm our office received the other stuff. I'm not sure that we, I'm not seeing any of that other stuff.
I'm honestly not surprised after what you just tried to explain to me. Okay, why don't we do this? I'm going to do what I can to try to contact Mr. Brown back, and I will again explain the same scenario to him. I will do my very best to do so. I would hope that you would not follow up with what I just explained to you to find out what more we can do with this. Because I know the Senate does have the ability to make the inquiry to the federal entities of which I'm trying to talk about. And it is obvious that if you would check their own websites and their own information, the fact of the medical anomaly just related to the Hitler Molar Mic anomaly and its gross ignoring or being ignored is fact as is. And that's a portion of what I'm contacting you about, that I'm trying to get get the Senate to understand that your federal agencies are abusing administrative law. They're abusing their own authority, whether they're creating rules and regulations outside of any context of vote of Congress and so on, or in Senate, and just simply allowing to forget their own value that they're supposed to be protecting the people, and allowing the gross negligence of free enterprise to just roll right over top of the American people completely. So that needs to be addressed, and that's why. So we'll cut this off. I'll let you contact them back. I've got your number. I'll contact you back in a couple of days. I've got my medical appointment I've got to deal with is on the 19th, so I'll set the appointment of where I'm going for surgery. We'll do my best to try to contact you, say, by the 19th to see where you stand.
Okay, that's fair.
I look forward to contacting you back.
Thank you, Mr. Anderson.
Have a nice day, sir.
You too.